students, now you can open the page number 16. This is the textbook activity of first lesson, Beware of the Man. First main, take the correct option to complete the following sentences. First one, baby tiger wanted to see man because. First option, he wanted to know why he should fear him. Second one, he wanted to make a friends with man. Third one, he was going to be king of the jungle. You know which is the right answer? First one. See, baby tiger wanted to see a man, right? Because he wanted to know why he should fear him. So, put the right mark to the first one. B one. Palm tree described man as someone who, first one, eats hay. Second one, has legs and walks around. Third one, dances all day. So, which is the right answer here? Second one, has legs and walks around. So put the right mark to the second one. Come to the third one. Baby tiger and monkey started to laugh because, first one, when they found man, he seemed to be more scared of them. Second one, man was tall and had no hair. Third one, they were scared of man. So which is the right answer here? First one. Okay. When they found man, he seemed to be more scared of them. Okay, so put the right mark to the first one. Come to the second main. Look here, state if the following sentences are true or false. Okay. A. Mama tiger told baby tiger one day he would defeat man. Is it true or false? False. See, mama tiger told baby tiger that, okay, one day he would be king of jungle, right? So this sentence is false. Write the F-A-L-S-E false word. Next, B1, baby tiger went off to look for man. So is it true or false? Yes, it is true. Write the true word in the blank. T-R-U-E, true. Third one, baby tiger found a rabbit and thought it was a man. Is it true or false? Yes, it is true. Write the true word in the blank. T-R-U-E, true. D1, the rabbit described man as small as a pup. Is it true or false? False. You can write the false word in the blank. F-A-L-S-E, false. E1, baby tiger was caught by a magician. Is it true? No, he caught by the man, right? So you can write the false word in there. F-A-L-S-E, false. So, now you can enter the page number 17. Third one, fill in the blanks. First one, baby tiger's mother told him to beware of dash. So, what is the answer? Man. Write the man word there. M-A-N, man. Second one, B. Baby tiger met dash through the tall grass. What he met? He met the rabbit. So, write the rabbit word in the blank. R-A-B-B-I-T, rabbit. C-1, baby tiger walked through the trees till he saw a dash. So what is the answer now? Palm tree. So write the palm tree there. D-1, baby tiger looked up at the trees and saw a dash jumping from branch to branch. So what is jumping now? Monkey. So write the monkey word there. M-O-N-K-E-Y, monkey. Next, E-1. Man was going to sell a baby tiger to the dash. So what is the answer? Zoo. So write the zoo word there. Z-O-O, zoo. So come to the fourth man. Answer the following questions in 30 to 40 words. Dear students, now you can try to get the answer from the textbook. What's the good word? First one, rewrite the sentences in your notebook using the opposite of the underlined words. Look here, children. Here they have given the sentence, right? A. The tall boy was running the race. You know, how do you rewrite this sentence in your notebook? Look here, children. This is the rewrite sentence, okay? So, instead of tall, I wrote here short. Because this is the opposite word of tall, right? The short boy was running the race. So, like this, you want to write in your class workbook, okay? C. B1. The boy used a hard ball to play the game. Okay, what is the opposite word of hard? See, they have underlined, right? That is a word. So, you want to find the opposite word of hard. So, what is the opposite word of hard? Soft. So, you want to write the soft word in the sentence. Okay? So, look here. The boy used a soft ball to play the game. So like this, you want to write the sentence. Next, third one. The small dog was taken for a walk. So small is a word, right? So you want to find the opposite of small. What is that? Big. Okay. See, look here. The big dog was taken for a week. So what is the opposite word of small? Big. Okay. So like this, you want to write the sentences in your class workbook. See, D1. The lady went to buy some fruit in the market. Okay. So what is the opposite word of buy? Sell. Okay. So you want to write the sell word in the sentence. Look here. The lady went to sell some fruits in the market. So instead of the buy, I wrote here sell. Okay. See, E1. Grandma was tired as she walked up the stairs. So what is the opposite word of up? Down. So you want to write the down word in the sentence. Look here. Grandma was tired as she walked down the stairs. So instead of up, I wrote here down. So like this. Okay, you can write the sentences in your class workbook. See, second myth. Match the words that mean the same. Okay, in the column A, they have given the words. In the column B, they have given the meaning words. Okay, what is the first one? Enemy. So what is the meaning of enemy? Enemy means foe. So you can match the enemy to foe. So like this, by using scale, you can match the enemy and the foe. Second one, shout. So what is the meaning of shout? Shout means scream. So you can match the shout and the scream. Next one, frightened. So what is the meaning of frightened? Frightened means scared. So you can match the frightened and the scared word. So fourth one, fast. What is the meaning of fast? Quick. So you can match the fast and the quick word. So like this, you want to complete this main. Okay, come to the third main. Circle the animals that belongs to the cat family. Dear students, here they have given some words, right? You want to find out, okay, which animal is related to the cat family. You can circle for that. So lion, is it a cat family? Yes, it is a cat family. So circle for that. Chimpanzee, is it a cat family? No, so you don't circle for that. Tiger, is it a cat family? Yes, you can circle for that. Next, dog, is it a cat family? No, you don't circle for that. Okay. Panther, so it's an animal, this is a cat family, so circle for the panther. Next, giraffe, it's not a cat family. Okay. Cow, it's not a cat family. Puma is a cat family. Okay, this is the animal, this is related to the cat family, so circle for the puma. So cheetah, is it a cat family? Yes, it's a cat family, so circle for the cheetah. Next, duck, it's not a cat family. Deer, it's also not a cat family. Leopard, it's a cat family, so circle for the leopard. So like this, you want to complete this main. Okay, shall we go to the next main? Yes, come here. What's the grammar behind it? Okay, fill in the blanks with suitable adjectives. So you want to fill the proper adjectives for the sentence. Okay, first one, the baby was playing with a dash ball. So which ball? That's a big ball. So write the big word there. Next, second one, the dash grasshopper was sitting on the leaf. See, how is the grasshopper? Grasshopper is green, right? So write the green word there. G-R-E-E-N, green. Seventh, the dash clown was clapping his hands. So how are the clowns? Clowns are funny, right? You can write the funny word there. F-U-N-N-Y, funny. Okay, next one. The dash whale was swimming near the shore. So which whale? That's a blue. So you can write the blue word there. B-L-U-E, blue. Eventh, the dash beetle was crawling on the ground. So how is the beetle? That's a little. Okay, you can write the little adjective there. So like this, you want to write the adjectives in the blanks. Okay. Dear students, now you can turn the page number 19. Underline the nouns in the following sentences. First one, as baby tiger walked on, he heard a sound on the trees. So you can find out the nouns and underline that. Okay. So which are the nouns in this sentence? Tiger and the trees. So underline the tiger and the trees. B, he saw a monkey jumping from branch to branch. So which are the nouns here? Monkey and branch. Okay, sir, underline the monkey and the branch. Next to C, man has no hair and tail. He has none. So which are the nouns here? Man, hair and tail. You can underline these three words. Next one, he pulled out a net and threw it over baby tiger. So which are the nouns here? Net and the tiger. So underline the net and the tiger. Last, even baby tiger began to cry for his mother. So which are the nouns here? Tiger and the mother. So underline the tiger and the mother. So like this you want to complete this main. Okay, come to the third main. Look here children, here punctuate the following sentences. So they have given sentences, right? So you can put the punctuation marks. Okay, A, we went on a holiday to Paris. See, first one they have given small letter, right? So instead of small letter W, you can write the capital letter W. Okay, we went on a holiday to Paris. Paris is a noun, right? So you can write the capital letter P. So you can like this, you want to write capital letter P. After the Paris, you can put the full stop. Okay. Next one, the girls asked, can we have some coffee? So always first you want to write capital, right? So instead of small t, you want to write the capital letter T, T-H-E, the, okay. The girls asked. After the asked, you put the comma. So after comma, can. Okay. So you can write the capital letter C. C. Can we have some coffee? Okay. So you can write the capital letter C. Before that, you want to write inverted commas. Okay. It means we are calling petition mark. Can we have some coffee? So after this sentence, I have put the question mark here because this is a question. Okay. The girls are asking, right? The girls ask, can we have some coffee? So put the question mark and close the inverted commas. Seventh, mother bought some flowers, cakes, cookies and balloons for the party. So mother, you want to write by the capital letter M. See, mother bought some flowers. Okay, after the flowers put the comma. Cakes, put the comma. Cookies and balloons for the party. Lastly, you can put the full stop. Next, D1. Jane and John bought some flowers for grandma. Okay. Jane and John, both are the nouns, right? So you want to write the capital letter J. See here, Jane and John. Okay, I have written the capital letters. Bought some flowers for grandma. Grandma is a noun, right? So you want to write the capital letter G. So after grandma, you can put the full stop. Next one. Even they had two cats, two birds and a dog named Bono. So they, you want to write a capital letter T there. So I have put the punctuation marks for the event. T, I have written the capital letters. They had two cats. After the cats, you can put the comma. Two birds and a dog. Okay, later comma. Named Bono. So Bono is a noun, right? You can write the capital letter B. Later put the full stop. So like this you want to put the punctuation marks for these sentences. Okay. Dear students, now we have completed the all textbook activity of the first lesson, right? So here is the project work for you. You can try to read and you can try to do this project work in your home. And you can practice the all textbook activity. Okay. Bye-bye.